Welcome to part 3 of the second module in our design fiction course. My name is Mehmet Aydın Baytaş. I'm a researcher in interaction design at Chalmers University of Technology, and I am going to offer you some thoughts and resources about how you can utilize design fiction in design work. So this short lecture is to introduce you to the second of the three readings in this module, which is called the 7-year glitch. This time, this is an example of design fiction. It's actually a short story. It's a work of literary design fiction. What's interesting about this short story is that it was published as a research paper. So even though the crux of the research paper, its main contribution, if you will, is not a physical virtual artifact, it's still kind of a good example of a research through design or constructive design research project in the showroom tradition that we spoke about before. So the crux of this paper is a short story told in first person from the voice of the protagonist. And the protagonist in this case is an iPhone. So we're reading the story from the point of view of an iPhone. And I think it's an older iPhone, maybe a 5 or 6 based on the pictures that they have with the boxy corners. So it's getting old. And the story begins at the point where the iPhone is starting to experience a problem. There's a glitch in its camera. So the pictures that the phone is taking, and some of them are included in the paper, are starting to look weird. Don't worry, I'm not going to tell you the whole story. I'm not going to give you any significant spoilers. So the story in itself already qualifies as a work of design fiction because, as you know, or as we think we know, iPhones are not conscious. They do not have thoughts and feelings, and they do not speak.
I'm really more of a listener.
But so in addition to being a work of design fiction, this story or this publication that contains the story, it also is a good example of design research. How come? If you recall from the previous reading, among the many purposes of constructive design research that is grounded in art and culture and speculation, one of them is to open up a space for debate. One purpose of design fiction artifacts or stories positioned within research as such is to reveal assumptions and beliefs and thoughts and subtleties of topics around their subject matter. This is one way for how works of design fiction can create and communicate knowledge. In particular, the story of the 7-year glitch does this in connection to the topics of consumption and sustainability and longevity in consumer electronics. By giving a voice to the iPhone, the story connects to the topics of artificial intelligence and the relationships between humans and technology, as well as the relationships between humans and humans, in this case as observed by the iPhone. The story leads us to reflect on our habits and culture around how we use and consume electronics, and how sometimes we might even find value and pleasure in imperfection and even malfunction. It brings, for example, the Japanese philosophy of wabi-sabi to the attention of the community of designers, engineers, and scholars that the paper is addressing. So would these topics be impossible to explore or unthinkable without having this particular story? Well, maybe not really. But if we think about the impact that this kind of work, this kind of literature makes on the reader, all of the things that we can think and feel when we read this work in fiction, and we compare that to the way we think and feel when we read through a more thorough and rigorous research paper, it is undeniable that this particular presentation of these ideas, realized as a work of design fiction, enriched with visuals, has a potential that a more dry and comprehensive and to-the-point research paper does not really have. So we had previously talked about research as knowledge production. What we did not mention in that previous discussion was that research also has two sides. There is the finding out new knowledge, there is discovering the new knowledge, but there's also representing communication of the new knowledge. So knowledge production is about finding out things and also communicating them to a new audience. In the case of the 7-year glitch, and perhaps more generally in the showroom tradition of constructive design research, it is the second aspect, the communication and representation of knowledge, which makes these works powerful. So this story, in my opinion, qualifies as constructive design research because of the unique power of the story in representing and communicating certain topics and concerns and questions and knowledge. Thus, it qualifies as knowledge creation. And this knowledge then enables other knowledge and debate, and most importantly for us, design. One other thing that you have to understand is that this paper, and in fact all research papers and perhaps all works of fiction and research and design and everything, all of them have a particular audience. The value of this paper and all kinds of works should be understood in relation to that audience and from the perspective of their audience. The 7-year glitch is written for an audience of designers, engineers, and academics and so on. And this is actually maybe around like 5,000-10,000 people who attend a conference called the CHI Conference on Human Factors in Computing. This is a venue for research in human-computer interaction and interaction design. Appropriately, as you will see in the paper itself, the story is also enriched by the inclusion of commentary on the sidebar that touches on the topics that are relevant for this audience. To this audience, it proposes questions and particular ways of using the topics and approaches that are embodied in the story. The story and the commentary also incorporate references or citations that refer to other research publications and other resources which are familiar and also relevant and useful to this particular community. So the 7-year glitch is a good example where literary fiction, and as you'll see in the paper also artistic photography, is employed as a design tactic within constructive design research. As I pointed out before, to become proficient as creators and users of design fiction, it's really important that you cultivate your own research skills. So please do take the time and go ahead and read this paper in full. So to summarize what we've covered so far, in this module of the course, you already know that we're trying to understand and clearly describe the place of design fiction within design work of all sorts. We've already established that design fiction has its greatest potential as a research activity, and particularly as constructive design research grounded in arts and culture. Based on that, in this lecture, I try to introduce you to a particular example of literary design fiction that sits within this research discipline. I pointed out how exactly this work qualifies as research or knowledge creation, and why it is relevant to an audience of researchers. Now, before we conclude this lecture, I feel that there's one outstanding question that we should address, and that is how such a work, such an example, might be useful in the context of professional design work. A short story as a particular result or a deliverable, an ultimate output of a design process, might not be viable in a commercial design assignment. If you think about the work that you would do as a designer, this is usually something visual. You're expected to deliver something physical, something tactical. A short story is not that. However, this form of storytelling, as well as functioning as research through design, it can also be useful as research for design. Thus, this kind of work can sit in the early and perhaps divergent stages of a design process to facilitate ideation and concept creation. There are a lot of people and resources that characterize the design process as an iterative process of convergence and divergence, where you work to create a lot of ideas and then you edit them down to particular definitions or solutions. From such a perspective, we can see that this kind of fiction and storytelling can fit very well into the earlier, the divergent phases of design, where you're trying to enlarge the space of ideas, possibilities, and thinking. As we see in the example of the 7-year glitch, this kind of literary fiction can also serve to articulate, communicate, and define certain ideas, concerns, and debates. These ideas and concerns can then impact the rest of your design process and the results that you will reach. For these reasons, I believe that reading and studying this particular example of literary fiction will be beneficial to you, regardless of what particular design-related academic or commercial activities you're involved in, especially since you're so interested in design fiction. I also personally found this story to be very engaging and very enjoyable. I think it's really well written, and for me, it was a great pleasure to read. So I hope that you will also feel this way about this paper.